Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the fall concert for the choir programs at the music program at Lindenwood University. We are part of the College of Arts and Humanities, and we are proud to share our music with you tonight. One change to the program, we are only singing the Gloria and not the Laudamus Te. From the first set, we decided to say the Laudamus Te for spring for you. This is kind of the prequel or the preview for us to sing the entire Francois Poulenc Gloria with the St. Louis Philharmonic Orchestra in March. So we hope you enjoy this and enjoy the concert. That was our combined choirs. We have three ensembles, Voices Only, Concert Choir, and University Chorus. A University Chorus meets in the evenings, and it is comprised of students as well as community members and many alumni from Lindenwood. So we're really excited about that group, and they're really excited to join the choirs in singing all of these major works and wonderful concerts. Just to give you another thing to look forward to, on Tuesday, November 28th, we are going to have a collaborative holiday concert with the choirs, the band, brass ensemble, and percussion ensemble, so you don't want to miss that. Let's ring in the holidays right after Thanksgiving, even though the stores have already done that. We're going to ring them in after Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
I'd like to give you a little word about the next two songs. These two kind of work together in our minds. Mental health has been a big issue for us in the last several years in our country. And we, as a choir, have talked about the problems that young people have and that people all over are having, and how mental health is becoming more talked about. And there are times when you just feel like you don't have the energy to go on. The song was written for a high school who had lost a student to suicide. It's called Please Stay. And the purpose of this song is to really let people know that you're not alone. You have someone for you. We are here for you. We're going to follow that with a song called Draw the Circle Wide, and it specifically states, no one stands alone. We'll stand side by side.
My happiness is no longer in the hands of someone else.
I realized that what people say about me reflects who they are, not who I am.
It's okay to be a work in progress.
Sharing your feelings doesn't make you weak.
Some days are still such a struggle.
I am strong, I am brave, I have faith.
All I can think about is Andrew. I just wish he kept living.
I decided to ask for help instead of going through it alone.
It was hard as hell, but I kept living.
all it takes.
Sure.
While University Chorus comes to the stage, I just want to explain that I am not abusing the students. They did those injuries on their own. It wasn't me, I promise. I would like to take the time to thank some folks, and I'm gonna get my notes. I'd like to thank our Performing Arts Department Chair, Emily Jones, for all of the support that she gives us, along with our Associate Deans, Shanika Harris and Travis McBacken, and our Dean, Kathy Bosevich. They have been so very supportive of our program and what we're trying to do here, and we just really appreciate that they have our backs and they're fighting to help us do the best that we can, so we appreciate them. I'd also like to thank Professor Adam Donahue and Tim Shackelford and the production crew. This concert is being run, the sound is being, and the logistics are being run by students. And Professor Donahue has trained them to do this. They're also video recording this concert, so this will be on our YouTube channel. If you go to Lindenwood University Music Program on YouTube, you'll see all of our concerts there. This one should be up in about 4 weeks. We'd also like to thank the You Can See Us, and the beautiful backdrop is thanks to Austin Van Winkle, who is our lighting technician here, and we really appreciate the beauty that he adds to this concert. We could not do these choral programs without what I consider the most important people in the room, and that is our accompanist. So I am so grateful to Brett Christofferson and Kathy Smith for supporting us in concert choir and university chorus with their wonderful piano skills and their amazing ability to assist in our rehearsals. I really appreciate that. One last note I would like to say, we are trying to save paper. We don't want to kill any more trees than we have to. So if you are interested in keeping your program as a keepsake, please keep it. But if you're not, there are some boxes at the exits, and we would appreciate it if you could just drop those in there because we could use them for our band concert. So if you come on Monday at 7:30, you'll hear our wind ensemble conducted by Dr. Sebastian Boots. And they have a wonderful, wonderfully diverse concert all ready for you on Monday at 7:30. Of course, we couldn't have a concert without you, so thank you so much for coming. We will wrap up our program with University Chorus.
Deepest, and he didn't believe. The same came
I chose this next piece especially for this group. I love intergenerational singing, and that's what we have here. We have some students here. We have Lindenwood alumni. We have family members singing together. It's just a wonderful community, and I love the fact that we have community members that can mentor and befriend our students and just kind of give them a little bit of wisdom from the world as our students are getting ready to go out into the world. This song is called It Is Not Always May, and the poetry talks about how you need to savor the time you have. Please enjoy It Is Not Always May.
I got a hog and a pig and a pen and corn to feed them. Oh,